No matter what your background is, you're probably seeing plants related to winter holidays this time of year. While they're mostly associated with Christmas, the use of decorative and symbolic plants in the wintertime dates back to pre-Christianity, and it has been recorded by ancient Egyptians, Hebrews, and Chinese, and was prominent in Norse and Roman empires as well. The Christmas tree is probably the best example of this phenomenon. Think of songs like, "Oh, Christmas tree, deck the halls with boughs of holly." One thing that seems to come up over and over as well is whether or not these plants are toxic, and which ones might or might not be poisonous. An article from the Chicago Tribune back in the 70s even said common plants may be poison, with the implication that these plants were potentially deadly to children. And this is something that people still wonder about to this day. While there are plenty of toxic evergreen plants, most of the ones used for decorations are pretty safe. So what else is there? Well, poinsettia, which is the scientific name Euphorbia pulcherrima, first achieved popularity after they were introduced from their native Mexico. By the 1920s, there were already unsubstantiated reports of poisonings, and these persisted for decades. Most of these referenced an unverified claim that a child in Hawaii, in 1919, died after eating a single poinsettia leaf. Many people to this day still believe poinsettias are toxic to humans because of this rumor. A review conducted in 1996 of 23,000 cases of exposure to poinsettias, like accidental ingestion, that were reported to poison centers around the U.S. found zero deaths, and actually showed that more than 90% of cases didn't even develop symptoms. And the only symptoms that were noted were just upset stomach, nausea, and vomiting. This makes sense because these are not edible plants, and symptoms are consistent with indigestible plant material. They might be more of a concern for household pets, and they can make pets sick, but still considered to be minimally toxic unless your cat or dog eats a lot of them. Let's talk about holly. Holly are the many species in the genus Ilex, and are also widely believed to be toxic. Are they, though? They're easy to identify because of their bright red berries that brighten up the dead of winter. English holly and winterberry are two species that are probably the most recognizable with their scalloped evergreen leaves. The berries of holly plants contain compounds called saponins. Saponins are plant-derived chemicals that have soap-like properties. When eaten, saponins can cause diarrhea, which is described as foamy because of their chemical properties like soap. They can also cause upset stomach, nausea, and vomiting. While they're considered to be toxic, it is once again more of an issue from eating something that your body isn't able to digest and that isn't supposed to be eaten. Holly leaves, on the other hand, contain some cool chemicals that act on the human body. Among the many chemicals in the leaves are a number of compounds called xanthines, and those include theobromine, theophylline, and caffeine. These primarily act as stimulants, like caffeine, and they can be toxic in overdose or certain situations, but they also can be consumed safely. Remember, the dose makes the poison. Theobromine is best known for being found in chocolate. It's thought to be the quote-unquote addictive compound in chocolate. It's also what makes chocolate toxic to dogs. Theophylline is actually used in medicine for the treatment of lung diseases like COPD and asthma, although it is used pretty rarely as it has more side effects and a smaller safety margin when compared to newer medicines. And caffeine is caffeine. Can definitely be consumed safely, but can also have problems. In fact, the leaves from several species of holly plants are actually brewed as tea for their caffeine content. If you've ever had a cup of the South American beverage yerba mate, then you are actually drinking holly tea. And yerba mate is made from the leaves of Ilex paraguensis. Oh ho, the mistletoe. Our last classic holiday plant to cover. Mistletoe are actually multiple different plants in the same family. They are considered parasites because they grow on the trunks and branches of trees and because they extract their water and nutrients that they need to survive from their host trees. European mistletoe, Viscus album, grows throughout Europe and has now been spread around the world. It's actually considered a problem in certain parts of California. It contains the toxin viscumin, which is mostly in its leaves, with far less in the distinctive white berries. The other mistletoe are in the genus Phorodendron and include American mistletoe, mistletoe, and false mistletoe. These plants also grow in most parts of the world. They contain the toxin phorotoxin. Hey, both of these toxins are easy to remember since they're named after the plant's Latin names. This is again primarily found in the leaves. Both of these toxins, phorotoxin and viscumin, are considered toxalbumins. Toxalbumins are proteins produced by plants that act on ribosomes to inhibit protein synthesis in animals. The classic example of a toxalbumin is ricin, and ricin is poisonous for the very reason that it stops your body from producing the vital proteins needed to live. The toxalbumins in mistletoe are very low potency, and unlike ricin, it's very difficult to ingest enough mistletoe leaves to cause severe poisoning, because again, the dose makes the poison. You would have to try really hard to eat that many inedible plant leaves, and I'd imagine it would make you sick for other reasons first. Primary symptoms of toxalbumin poisoning include delayed GI upset, things like nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and stomach pains that can lead to dehydration. However, theoretically, this could progress to organ failure, like ricin, if enough was consumed. So while most of these plants are pretty benign, they probably don't taste great, and at the very least can cause some digestive issues, with mistletoe maybe being more of a cause for concern than holly and poinsettias. The best bet is to only use mistletoe for decoration and for kissing underneath. As long as you don't eat it, you should have a holly jolly time.